India's workforce is young, India's economy is dynamic, India's growth prospects are huge. But I want to ask you, what kind of economy will drive India into the future?
Many of us are still stuck in the 20th century paradigm of development versus environment. Whereas in the time that we are living in, it has to be development and environment.
The answer is very clear that if India needs to become a Viksit Bharat, it has to be a green economy.
An economy which regenerates, which includes, and which sustains.
Green is not a cost. Green is an investment. Green is an opportunity.
Green is not tomorrow. Green is now. Green is here.
Green is the new gold.
A green economy is planet positive, people-centered, but market-oriented. It's not just about moving from dirty energy to clean energy. A green economy is about rethinking what kinds of goods and services we produce, how we produce them, and with what materials we produce them.
At one end, it is about energy transition, but it is also about a circular economy, where your waste actually becomes wealth, be it spent cooking oil becoming sustainable aviation fuel, or be it your textile waste becoming new fresh fabric again. But it's also about bioeconomy and nature-based solutions, where you move from fossil-based plastics to bioplastics.
We are having a 5,000 tons in a year processing of batteries has been done in our company. In terms of manpower, today we are close to 70 people on rolls and close to 150 people on blue-collar employees, which is working all three shifts. We have a vision to have jobs of close to 5,000 people directly or indirectly into this domain, which will cover supply chain engineering, technology, production, sales, as well as collection of batteries from the market.
We are still bootstrapped and we have grown from 7 lakhs to till we have come to 10 CR, and then you know we are on our way to 15 CR, and now we take it to 50 CR, then 100 CR.
When it comes to DRE products, just like you have a consumer awareness gap, you have a financier awareness gap. Financiers like NBFCs, banks, MFIs need to know what these products are, whether these products are robust, durable, whether they generate income and how much income.
So really, if one could think about systematically tackling each of these sectors, there is a lot of money to be made, a lot of progress to be made, and a lot of technological innovations to be made. All of us are looking at innovations, which of course come from startups because they are faster, nimbler, which can systematically build technology, which don't make another shift, but step shift in how things are.
India is right now a $4 trillion economy. We are aiming to be a $35 plus trillion dollar economy by the time we become 100 in 2047. There's a huge opportunity to my mind to go green entirely, not merely in our thinking, but in our processes, in our manufacturing, and our ability to technologically leapfrog in a green manner.
Unlocking this massive green economic opportunity needs Samaj, Sarkar, and Bazaar to come together. Take Odisha, for example, where the government has created a committee of 16 secretaries of the state who are overseeing Odisha's economic diversification.
For us, it is very important to weave in our peculiar positioning with respect to climate into whatever economic plans we have. For example, we have 33% of our area under forest. How do I ensure that people living there also are growing economically? While we are able to sustain the forest, we are able to sustain the water, we are able to sustain the environment, we are very happy that we are among the first few states to have embraced green economy as a concept.
I'm happy to share that India would be taking a leadership role in promoting green economy.
During the India's G20, we came up through a huge process of debate, discussion and consultation, the Green Development Pact, which talked about climate action, which talked about sustainability.
We're seeing a disruption in the fossil fuel industry. We're seeing a disruption in the energy industry. We're seeing a disruption in mobility. Industries that have lasted for like 200 odd years are now being attacked by new businesses, new ideas that are coming in and essentially changing the rules of the game. changing the boundaries within which you play with, how is that not a profit-making opportunity? And that is investing. That's, you would choose the right thing, while at the same time, you are going to be able to see that impact. You will see societies change.
If we put these trillions of dollars of investment, if we transform India's economy to make it truly a net zero green economy, we're going to drive dramatic economic growth for India. And the growth that we are going to see, the returns that we're going to see, the money and the wealth creation that we're going to see is so enormous that it is something we cannot even conceive of right now.
We need to celebrate risk so that India can boldly chart a path forward, not just for itself as potentially the largest green economy in the world, but also set an agenda for how the world shifts towards a more sustainable development pathway.
Let's change the color of our economy.